viewers, today we will talk about anaerobic respiration. We know that all living organisms, including plants, get their energy by the process of aerobic respiration. But in the anaerobic respiration, here incomplete oxidation of glucose takes place and the end product is ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. Energy released is much less than that of aerobic respiration. We know that there are two types of anaerobes, obligate anaerobes and facultative anaerobes. Obligate anaerobes, poisoned by oxygen, gather at the bottom of the tube, carry out fermentation. Facultative anaerobes grow with or without oxygen, makes ATP by aerobic respiration if oxygen is present. Switch over to aerobic respiration if oxygen becomes available. In anaerobes, other electron acceptor replaces oxygen. The first step of respiration is glycolysis. Glucose molecules is converted into two molecules of pyruvate and two molecules of ATP is produced. If oxygen is present, in case of aerobic respiration, pyruvate molecules go through two other stages, that is Krebs cycles and electron transport chain. And here high amount of energy is released in the form of ATP. If oxygen is absent, that is in a case of anaerobic respiration, two other stages, that is Krebs cycle and electron transport chains, are bypassed. Pyruvate is converted into different byproducts through fermentation and carbon dioxide is released. Less amount of energy is released in the form of ATP. We know that term fermentation is used after the name of the products like alcoholic fermentation and lactic acid fermentation. During ethanol formation, that is in alcoholic fermentation, first pyruvate is converted to acetaldehyde and carbon dioxide in the presence of TPP and magnesium and in the presence of an enzyme pyruvate decarboxylase. After that, it is converted to ethanol in presence of an enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase, and it occurs in bacteria and in yeast. During lactic acid formation, pyruvate is converted to lactic acid in presence of an enzyme lactate dehydrogenase, which also requires FMN and zinc. It occurs in lactic acid bacteria, that is in lactobacillus, in some fungi, animal muscles tissue, and in number of the plant tissues, mainly potato tuber. Lactic acid produces in muscle is sent to liver to regenerate glucose. Here no carbon dioxide is produced. We know that heart plants are obligate aerobes which tolerate anoxia for only short periods. In roots of some waterlogged plants, soil is saturated with water. No oxygen available as a terminal electron acceptor. Mitochondrial respiration will shut down. Metabolism will shift over to fermentation. Anaerobic respiration is exclusive mode of respiration in some parasitic worms, many prokaryotes, several unicellular eukaryotes, and also in molds. Pyruvic acid can be converted into wide variety of other products, namely acetic acid, propionic acid, butyric acid, formic acid, etc., besides lactic acids and ethyl alcohol by different types of bacteria. Ethyl alcohol not stayed inside microorganism but is excreted. Accumulation of alcohol beyond a certain limit kill the microorganism. Example, 30% in yeast. A high concentration of alcohol in beverages is achieved through distillation. In aerobic condition, lactate and pyruvate dehydrogenase are inactive. Due to lower levels of NADH and high levels of NAD+ and ATP would limit the production of lactate from pyruvate. In anaerobic condition, lactate produced by means of lactate dehydrogenase, pH of the medium falls, pyruvate decarboxylase then becomes active, initiates the production of ethanol. In alcoholic fermentation, acetaldehyde is finally reduced to ethanol by NADH in the presence of alcohol dehydrogenase. Therefore, lactic acids or ethanol is the end products of alcoholic fermentation, results in the formation of 2 moles of ethanol and 2 moles of carbon dioxide per mole of glucose metabolized. Anaerobic respiration produces very little energy, that is about 5% as compared to aerobic respiration. Here, incomplete breakdown of respiratory substrate. At least one of the product of anaerobic respiration is organic and it can be further oxidized to release energy. NADH produced during glycolysis is often used up. ATP formation does not occur during regeneration of NAD+. Electron transport chain is absent. Oxygen is not used for receiving electrons and protons. Importance of anaerobic respiration. Here, during alcoholic fermentation, which is used in brewing industry for the production of various types of beers, whiskey, and other wines. Carbon dioxide of alcoholic fermentation is used in baking industries for making the bread spongy. Vinegar by fermentation activity of acetic acid bacteria. Dairy industry depends upon lactic acid bacteria which converts milk sugar to lactic acid. Lactic acid coagulates the milk protein, casein, and the droplets of milk fat use. Production of industrial alcohols and organic acids. Tea and tobacco leaves cured and provided with a fine flavor. Rating or separation of stem fibers is carried out with the help of bacterial fermentation of softer tissue. Preserved fodder is prepared by keeping green chopped fodder in silo where bacterial action causes softening and releasing of preserving acid. Cleaning of raw hides is a fermentative bacterial activity. Decomposition of organic remains is carried out by fermentation. Fermenting organisms spoil food, causes food poisoning by releasing toxins or potamines. Food is oxidized without using molecular oxygen. Found in anaerobic bacteria, yeast, many parasitic animals like tinea, fascicula, ascaris, etc. The respiration is called anaerobic respiration. In microorganism, fermentation is commonly used in place of anaerobic respiration. Fermentation is defined as anaerobic breakdown of carbohydrates and other organic compounds into alcohols, organic acids, gases, etc. with the help of microorganisms or their enzymes. The term fermentation is known after the name of the products like alcoholic fermentation and lactic acid fermentation. For example, yeast oxidizes glucose to ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide without using oxygen. In muscles, certain bacteria, parasitic worms like tinea and ascaris, glucose is metabolized to lactic acid without utilizing oxygen and without the formation of carbon dioxide. In cellulose fermentation, cellulose is converted into volatile fatty acids by anaerobic bacteria and protozoa as found in the rumen and reticulum. In skeletal muscles, lactic acid is produced from glucose during vigorous exercises. Not get as much oxygen as it is necessary for their work. This results in muscular pain. In mammalian erythrocytes, which lack mitochondria, carry out anaerobic respiration. Lactic acids produced anaerobically and it is oxidized aerobically by other tissues, example, liver and cardiac muscles. Sometimes animal and plant cells cannot get enough oxygen to carry out aerobic respiration, still needs to obtain energy to stay alive. Use an emergency system of reaction, that is anaerobic respiration. In animals, when we sprint for a bus, our muscles use so much oxygen. We cannot supply it in a time, so we cannot use aerobic respiration. Instead, we use anaerobic respiration. How long could we sprint? Not very far before things get very sore. This way of getting energy is not efficient as aerobic respiration. Leaves up poisonous chemicals, lactic acids. It stops our muscles working and we get sore. When we stop, the lactic acid is slowly destroyed, but that needs oxygen. The amount of oxygen we need for this is called oxygen depth. In plants, if the roots of the plants get waterlogged, starts to run out of oxygen, need to use a different type of anaerobic respiration. And this reaction is also used by yeast cells when they make bread or alcoholic drinks. Lactic acids, ethanol is poisonous. It affects brain cells. If there is too much ethanol produced, it will kill the cells. So it must be got rid of by using oxygen in aerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration using electron acceptors other than molecular oxygen. Although oxygen is not the final electron acceptor, the process still uses a respiratory electron transport chain. In aerobic organism undergoing respirations, electrons are shuttled to an electron transport chain and the final electron acceptor is oxygen. Molecular oxygen is highly oxidizing agent and is an excellent electron acceptor. In anaerobes, other less oxidizing substances such as sulfate, nitrate, sulfur or fumarate are used. These terminal electron acceptors have smaller reduction potentials than oxygen and less energy is released per oxidized molecules. So anaerobic respiration is less efficient than aerobic. As compared with fermentations, there are two important microbial methane formation pathways, carbonate reduction and acetate fermentation. Cellular respiration in both aerobic and anaerobic utilizes highly reduced chemical compounds such as NADH and FADH2. Establish an electrochemical gradient across a membrane resulting in an electrical potential or ion concentration difference across the membrane. The reduced chemical compounds are oxidized by a series of respiratory integral membrane proteins with subsequently increasing reduction potential. With the final electron acceptor being oxygen in a case of aerobic respiration and other chemical substances in case of anaerobic respiration. A proton motive force drives protons down the gradients through the proton channel of ATP synthase. The resulting current drives ATP synthesis from ADP and inorganic phosphate. Fermentation is the process which not utilize an electrochemical gradient. Use substrate level phosphorylation to produce ATP. The electron acceptor NAD plus regenerate from NADH formed in oxidative steps of the fermentation pathway by the reduction of oxidized compounds which are formed during the fermentation pathway itself but may also be external. For example, in Homo fermentative lactic acid bacteria, NADH, formed during the oxidation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is oxidized back to NAD plus by the reduction of pyruvate to lactic acid at a later stage in the pathway. In case of yeast, acetaldehyde is reduced to ethanol to regenerate NAD plus. Anaerobic respiration is a critical component of the global nitrogen, iron, sulfur and carbon cycles through the reduction of oxyanions of nitrogen, sulfur and carbon to more reduced compounds. Significantly impacts on the carbon cycle and global warming occurs in many environments including freshwater and marine sediments, soil subsurface aquifers, deep subsurface environments and biofilms. Soil also contains oxygen, also have microenvironments that lack oxygen due to slow diffusion characteristics of the oxygen gas. Use of nitrate as a terminal electron acceptor. Denitrification is a process where fixed nitrogen is returned back to the atmosphere as a molecular nitrogen. Methanogenesis is the process where it enters the atmosphere gas by anaerobic digestion, used as sustainable alternative to fossil fuels. On the negative side, uncontrolled methanogenesis in landfill sites release large volumes of methane into the atmosphere, acts as a powerful greenhouse gas. Sulfate respiration produces hydrogen sulfide, which has a characteristic rotten egg smell of coast wetlands. Precipitate heavy metal ions from solutions, deposition of sulfidic metals ores. Denitrification mainly used in the removal of nitrate and nitrite from the municipal wastewater. Excess nitrate lead to eutrophication of waterways into which treated water is released. Elevated nitrate levels in drinking water lead to problems due to its toxicity, converts both compounds into harmless nitrogen gas. Anaerobic denitrification takes place in some bacteria, occurs in the plasma membrane of the prokaryotes. Nitrate goes through respiratory dehydrogenase. Each reductase loses oxygen through each step, so that final product is nitrogen. Microorganisms convert toxic chemicals into less harmful molecules to clean up contaminated beaches, aquifers, lakes and oceans. Toxic arsenate or selenate can be reduced to less toxic compounds by various anaerobic bacteria. Reduction of chlorinated chemical pollutants such as vinyl chloride and carbon tetrachloride occurs through anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration is useful in generating electricity in microbial fuel cells. Bacteria which respire solid electron acceptor to transfer electrons from reduced compounds to an electrode. This process can simultaneously degrade organic carbon waste and generate electricity. During intense exercise, muscles use oxygen to produce ATP faster than we can supply it. Muscle cells perform glycolysis faster than they can supply oxygen to the mitochondrial electron transport chain. Lactic acid formation occurs within our cells after prolonged exercise. Built up lactic acids can make muscles sore. During alcoholic drinks, yeast perform alcoholic fermentation with a solution of a sugar and other flavoring compounds. Uses complex carbohydrates, namely potatoes, grapes, corn, and many other organs as a sources of sugars. Kept yeast and its fuel sources in an airtight bottle to produce the alcohol. Toxic when alcohol concentration becomes high enough, the yeast will begin to die. Not possible to brew a wine or beer that has a greater than 30% alcohol content. Distillation separates alcohol from other components of the brew, can be used to produce hard liquors. Methanol produced from fermentation of a different sugars found in plants. Cellulose is fermented into methanol, results will be dangerous. The dangers of the cheap home-brewed liquor which contains high amounts of methanol due to poor brewing and distillation process. Death and nerve damage from methanol poisoning is still an issue in area where unskilled people try to brew alcohol cheaply. Propionic acid fermentation gives Swiss cheese its distinctive flavor. Holes in the Swiss cheese made by bubbles of carbon dioxide gas. Bacteria responsible for making of vinegar, which requires two fermentation process. Bacteria first makes acetic acid require alcohol as fuel. First fermented into alcoholic preparation such as a wine, alcoholic mixture is fermented again using the acetogenic bacteria. Anaerobic respiration uses for a short period when supply of oxygen is low. A runner on a track field takes an aerobic respiration to start up. It takes few seconds for increased amount of oxygen they need to get into their muscle cells. During this short time, anaerobic respiration is used to make ATP to fuel our muscles as they run. Not favorable as only 2 ATP are produced compared to aerobic respiration where 36 molecules of ATP are produced. It is unfavorable due to lactic acid production, and lactic acid is toxic when it builds up in the cell, felt as a burning feeling in muscles as they fatigue, last a maximum for 20 seconds. After that, aerobic respiration usually takes over. That is, it is buildup of lactic acid, leaps of oxygen depth, needs to take a minute to catch their breath after an intense exercise such as sprint. When lactic acid is to be broken down, it is no longer harmful to the cell. How does it apply to the sports? Many athletes, anaerobic respiration helps with short burst of energy. Train to lengthen the time goes on their cells, increases the amount of lactic acids. During training, high intensity exercise such as jumping or sprinting for a short period of time repeatedly lengthen the amount of time their body spends on anaerobic metabolism. Useful in sports such as baseball or football. At last, we can say that anaerobic respiration proceeds in the absence of oxygen. No further production of ATP molecules. Pyruvic acid is converted into lactic acids and into the ethanol and carbon dioxide, and the reaction is reversible. Restore stocks of NAD+, pyruvate levels restores in the presence of oxygen, greater yield of ATP aerobically. Lactate production in the human maximizes the power of muscles contraction, expenditure of high amounts of energy, so require high levels of ATP. Exercising at high intensity energy demands will exceed what the available level of oxygen can supply aerobically. Breaking down of glucose anaerobically to maximize ATP production. Increased production of lactic acid causes muscles fatigue. If we stop exercising, oxygen levels increases, lactate converted back to the pyruvate. Only carbohydrate undergo anaerobic respiration, produces energy without using oxygen. Instead, sulfate, nitrate or sulfur is used. This aerotolerant bacteria not having enzymes necessary to go through the TCA cycle, carry out fermentation, even they are growing under aerobic conditions. There are the three fates of pyruvate produced by glycolysis. During aerobic oxidation, pyruvate is converted to carbon dioxide, water and energy through Krebs cycle and electron transport chain. But during lactic acid fermentation, pyruvate is converted to lactate and here no carbon dioxide is released. But during alcoholic fermentation, pyruvate is converted to ethanol and the intermediate product is acetaldehyde and here carbon dioxide is produced. Thank you.